And welcome back. We are in the... Palagina. We are in the catacombs underneath Copperlane, the Copperlane district. And we have explored this whole side so far. A bunch of background messages and stuff here, and some loot. I haven't explored this side yet, and we're going this way for now. There's a room here. Full of slimes or what? Oh, lovely. More backer messages. Oh, and we break. There's another way out. See if there's a trap on this thing. Oh, stairs down. That's what. A potion of major regeneration. Excellent. Blue-green liquids. Plus 72 endurance over 15 seconds. Awesome. I really haven't been using these things. And, 35 golden... I think those were dukes. I wasn't really looking. Let's see. See, we have one already. Oh no, it's Spirit Shield. Never mind. Let's see what messages we have here. Sheliasks. Oh yeah, that's a placeholder. Dedicated to the memory of Stephen Lynch, 1966 through 2002, my cousin and first gaming buddy, R.I.P. These years are not familiar to me. Mosco. Bellumel. What I know can fill a book. What I don't know can fill libraries. Simon Buchan. Hi, Mom. Skuphundaku. Red Troll number 9739 of the Codex. Here lies Red Troll number 9739 of the Codex. He is buried with his evil black arquebus. It was impossible to pry it out of his cold, dead hands. Dr. Jeremy Barnes. Loving father, husband, and healer, dedicated seeker of adventure and loot, proud member of the great clan of the Redbirds. Smack. Over, done with. This place. No time here. No future. Prashnak, nullifier of Orkney. Hails from the Dale with winds of ice, a codex bespoke. Abjurer, artificer, trollbane, mentions of bracers of pearl. In the end, a king, a goblin griff, a lucky shot. A planeswalk, Iara, for not. A zombie. He tried hard, but remained second eternally. Sorry, sec. XD, or laughing hysterically, face. Julian A. Farad. Blank. Tae Yang Kim. Never bother me again, or my wrath will be great indeed. Cryhog. Sometimes success can be eked out of a humble, difficult life. Taharis, Obsidian Enthusiast. Teoa, come back at night in a fortnight, and thou shalt be greatly rewarded. Somehow I doubt it. Tazn Taylor, a longtime gamer who loves it so much, I will either die by my wife or at my PC. Oh, in either way, they will have to pry the controller from my cold, dead hand. I do love real life, too. Prying things from hands seems to be a popular theme. Pua Chi Hao. Chrisan, the four happiest moment in my life is meeting you, getting married with you, having our twins, sons, and now you're pregnant with our daughter. I love you, and there will be more such moments for us. Awkwardly spoken, but okay. Te Penizer. Exceptionally average. Yasmin Fazg. Died from a sneaky wall orc. Turdog. Rests with his companion Willow. Oh.
Following your lead.
We saw Willow in another area. I think that's the same Willow. Alright, so before we go downstairs...
Of course.
We'll continue exploring this level. Getting kind of cavernous here. Ooh. Skeletal fighter. Interesting. I don't know if arrows would do much against bones, but why not? And Idair can actually use his knockdown attack. Another one. Okay. Who's this in front? Palagina? Alright. Knockdown. Five thrust, boom. They're probably gonna stay around here, so. Well, we can't get through. He's freaking out, this guy. The doorway. Can I change who I'm casting this on? Off of Palagina. Who's stuck back here? Canna? Can't get through. Shoot him. Who's this? Theodas. Durance. Aloth. Idair is all the way back here. Cool.
Margrin's fire casts light.
Yeah. Okay, poleaxe, vessel bones.
Eight in dark places.
Interesting. Oh my god, was it decorated with skulls? What manner of place is this? Well, at least we can all hit our foe now that we're in the room. Some of us already had ranged equipped.
Eh?
Go! Oh my god, these guys run, and there's a lot of them. Human skeleton, skeletal fighter, human skeleton, skeletal wizard, skeletal wizard, oh boy. I don't know if mind things work on these things. I mean, they're skeletons, they're basically mindless, right? Otherwise, I'd try mind blades, but I don't know. I'll just stick with the normal. Minor missile there. Knock down there. Holy Radiance. Holy Radiance, Batman. Flames of Devotion. Boom.
Achilles.
Okay. We haven't fought him yet. Okay. Ooh, he got hit. still haven't finished this? Okay. You are going for him, right? I mean, there's like blood all over the place. What the hell? Okay, now Soul Shock off of Adair. Wizards. Boom. Shield, or armor of faith, what have you. Boom. My other flames of devotion go right here.
Following yours.
That's it!
So we're out of focus, we're gonna run into melee. Knocked down. She didn't get to use her other flames of devotion, so use it on him.
Eh?
Yeah, it's pausing because we're all damaged. Oh, it looked like a human falling there, doesn't it? Hello!
Yeah. Let's go!
Let's go! Awesome. Who's this?
How may I help?
Say a lot, huh? A rod, sword, shields, vessel bones.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. I don't see a need to sneak right now, so.
Got it.
Actually, we should just in case.
Nice and quiet.
There's hidden things, we can find them. I forget sometimes the dual way of sneaking. Okay, we'll check him out in a second. Can't even select him right now. Not trapped. A crossbow. 46 silver fennings. And a potion of power. Incorporating the restorative, if volatile, powers of necromancy, tinged bones. Oh, powers of necromancy, tinged bones. This foul smelling but potent elixir is of undeniable worth in a fight, for it can give even the most hapless of fighters the effectiveness of an aged veteran. I say use a couple of these potions. Oh, is he full, Aeloth? Yeah, he's got all these tomes. Oh, we don't need him carrying this rod. Or this pole axe. Yeah. I guess if you hit take all, it goes into inventory. I don't want that. Well, he's got his fish. Oh, right. I forgot to add this to her. Ring of Unshackling. Still got this dragon meat. Put in a... Oh, we have one already? Push of Power, we do. Okay. Put that back. Oh, is another adventure. Are these These aren't ones we've destroyed. They're just a corpse. Leather armor. Anything special about this thing? Okay, so we've got two ways off of here, obviously, so let's head towards this corpse. A pistol. Oh, crap! Get him out of here! Ow? Glyph of warding or something? Middle letters, bounding missile spell. Huh. Well, that sucks.
And what does the flame reveal?
Now we gotta keep pulsing like this. Is it supposed to do that? Ooh, trap detected here.
And the fire shows me something new.
Oh, yeah.
Tell me.
Something dangerous. Don't go. I'm clicking back here and they're going forward.
Hmm?
How do I stop that from happening?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes. Morgan Freeman.
Quay?
Quay? That's one way to do it. Oh, hello. Helig of Thein. Greetings. We've bypassed your traps. What prizes lay in store for us? A lone figure in tattered robes shuffles across the chamber, muttering under its breath as you approach. The figure halts and swivels its head toward you. Its haggard visage is a labyrinth of wrinkles and sores overgrown by a moss-like beard. What's this? Who disturbs Helig's work? Its voice rattles and gurgles like that of a drowning man. What are those creatures behind you? Do we see creatures, or we're just trying to fool this guy, I guess? You're Helig? Dalton sent me here to look for Rowyna. Does he know either of them? I forget. He leans back and bursts into raucous laughter. His threadbare robes drift apart, revealing an amulet and a ragged wound running from chest to throat. It spatters a black, viscous fluid on the floor with every cackle. You should really have that looked at, you know. That old fool is still alive. I do hope he doesn't bear a grudge for that incident. It was so very long ago. You may want to get that looked at. Since I said it, I feel like I have to actually say it. What, this? He points a gnarled thumb at the wound. Heh, a long story. I was one of the first animancers in the Deerwood. Practiced necromancy, too. Which is what Dalton and his Northwatch Rangers... Well, which is what put Dalton and his Northwatch Rangers on my trail. He cackles, making a wet burbling sound. What can you tell me about Dalton? Only that it's a miracle, or a joke, of the gods that he's still alive. He picks a bloodied crust from his beard. The only thing that he loved more than his fetching lieutenant was the idea of his own legend. This might provoke an attack. Let's just say he claims to hear her voice. The wound oozes as he chuckles. Oh, I'm sure. She never did know when to hold her tongue. I'll make a deal with you. I can help you find Rowyna, but I need you to visit an animancer named Modred first. Number two. Alright, what do you need me to do? When animancy started gaining popularity, I came to Defiance Bay in hopes of finding a place where my research would meet with more acceptance. Worked at the Brackenberry Sanitarium for a few months when I met Modred. He spits a gob of black blood on the floor. Yuck. Let's say Modred and I didn't see eye to eye. Got so bad we were threatening to kill each other on a daily basis. Obviously that bastard made good on his threat. He runs a jagged fingernail along his oozing wound. Sank a dagger into my chest while I was sleeping and dumped my body in the catacombs. If Modred killed you, how are we having this conversation? I'd preserve my mind and my memories with Inguithin magic and a few timely preparations. He looks at his rotting hands. Yet now my soul is anchored to this decaying husk. His claw-like hands clench into fists. Modred stole a life from me and left me with this wrecked corpse and this craving. He clutches at his stomach and glances at you hungrily, but only for a second. Oh, he wants to eat us up. Nom nom. Modred keeps all that is precious to him in a trunk in his laboratory, just as he stole my grimoire. He offers you a key with a claw-like hand. Cool, so maybe we can advance further into the sanitarium, which is what I really wanted to do. On your way to Brackenberry Sanitarium, then. Bring me my grimoire and my revenge, and you can have your Rowyna. He chokes on a burbling chuckle. If there's nothing else, be on your way. What are you doing down here? Research. A hodgepodge of animancy and necromancy. I have peace and quiet as well as an abundant supply of subjects. What are those creatures behind you? Just a few personal projects. Sorry souls stuck in their mortal shells. Their flesh is as dead as mine, though their minds are not as well maintained. They flock to me like worms to drakes. They're not half as intelligent, but... He watches as one stumbles into a desk. They serve for amusement. I was just exploring the catacombs you have here. Nice place. The finger aims a gnarled figure at the door. Then go, and thank your gods I'm not hungry. Well, your stomach was growling. Farewell. So he's the wizard who killed Rowyna. Retrieve his grimoire. Okay. Are there creatures here? Oh yeah. Revenants. Or revenants. Dust and cobwebs have been swept aside for various alchemical implements, though coated with rust and grit, they look recently used. A grim assortment of rusty blades adorns this table. Can I just look what's in here?
I'll see what I can find.
Not trapped. I just want to look. Ooh, tarnished locket. The scattered, feverish notes detail various animantic procedures and rites of necromancy. Yeah, interesting. So I guess we go around here.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
More traps. Back this way.
Something over there.
Yeah, a boo-boo maker.
On your word.
Aye.
Eh?
Eh?
Hey.
It's interesting how much you can see of these personalities displayed in the simple hey and huh.
Tell me.
Their personalities are alive even in that.
Yeah.
Oh, crap, we're right on it.
And the fire shows me something new.
Don't step on that one. And this... Oh, we've been this way. Okay. I'd double back, but we'd have to go past the other trap. Can we disarm this thing? Actually, we get points, don't we?
What?
Experience points.
That's settled. You can trust me.
Yeah, I really trust you. You're telling me that you succeed when you fail.
That's settled.
Oh, excellent. Good.
Yeah.
Now this I haven't seen before. That's settled.
Damn it.
What?
I said damn it. That's a hard one to get through too.
How may I help?
Following your lead.
Quay?
Yes?
Quay, I like that. Quay?
On your word.
Next time someone calls out my name and wants to talk to me, I'll just be like, Quay?
Hey.
And they'll be like, alright.
Quay?
Quay.
Yeah.
Well, I don't need to sneak now. I want to run back really quick and find this other trap. I want to see if he can disarm this one.
What? That's settled.
Nope.
Sure.
Not settled. Maybe next time we come down here, we'll gain a level, or he'll gain a level, and then that'll be settled. Alright. So explore this whole complex here. We can go across the bridge and check out the rest.
Slowly now.
Hunting wabbits. I love the water. It's awesome. More stuff. You shouldn't be able to see on the other side, no fair. Game lets me cheat. How do we get down there? Oh. I thought we were on... What? Oh, this is an archway. I thought this was elevated and that was running underneath. Never mind. That's right, there was a door. all the way back here that we didn't open. More backer messages. A morning star. Have you ever looked at those? The big brother of the mace. Morning stars are two-handed weapons topped with a spike head. They lack the armor penetrating power of maces, but are effective against a wider range of armor types. Into the stash it goes. Okay, Granny. Little Granny, old and fragile, constantly on the move and never finding rest. Although she's quite agile, she never seems to find her nest. Caragouche. I'm not trying to read that. Insanity Prawn Boy? Ah, my wise Wordle, I once met a group named for a rock dark as night. I gave them my bones and they gave me this stone. Oh dear Wordle, I think all is right. Wordle, oh Wordle, Wordle woo. Okay, Prince Reynard. Little of note, big of girth, and open of wallet. His faith is rewarded here, resting on the benevolence of his beloved wife. Adepto Lange Mei Testiculorum Tustas Super. Does that mean he has big balls or something? Eric Redrose. A veteran warrior of the sea lies here. He traveled the world twice over, but no enemy born could slay him. Only the Time's icy embrace was able to lay this one low. Pie. Here lies Pie. He lived as he died, face down in blueberry pie. R.I.P. Phonot. Blank. Raculot. Blank. Ziggy. Ad infinitum et ultra. Catch a shooting star and put it in your pocket. Just try not to make a liar out of yourself. Lord Winfield. Here lies Lord Winfield. In death may he find his peace that eluded him in life, and his gold, and his house keys, and his marbles. R.J.S. To absent friends, lost loves, old gods, and the season of mists, and may each and every one of us always give the devil his due. Rich Rockwood. This poor soul passed when a fireball spell misfired. Sasha F. In love forever, Patricia S. Fayed. Always crying with sad. ESCC. Aste. Was it worth it? Sableus. Roses are red, violets are blue. Ome wa mu shindiru. Anoweha, father to Odin, a.k.a. Der Thak Shadow Wolf. To your son, Odin, may you outshine your name. To my friends, live long and do whatever. To all, Neverwinter Nights and Neverwinter Nights 2 consume much of my life. Shoab Khan. Everything in life is an extrapolation. Architect of the Goose and Fox Inn. Hmm. Well, that actually fits here. Alright. Alright, let's go see what's in the door. Eorn? Huh. This small Orland man appears to have pulled together some crates and scraps of cloth to make a rather sorry-looking camp. The thick fur on his limbs is matted, and his clothing smeared with blackening grime. He looks startled as you enter, his eyes widening in alarm. Eorn sounds familiar. Are we supposed to be looking for him or something?
How do you do?
After a moment, however, he smiles weakly. Hello there. Wasn't expecting any visitors down in these parts. He glances around the dim room. Right. Well, let's save number one. What are you doing down here? He grimaces. I've been a little down on my luck lately. Didn't have anywhere to stay, so I thought I'd come down here. Nobody pokes around in the catacombs much. Not until you, anyway. Let's go find. Let's talk about something else. Eorn releases the breath he was holding. Yes, let's. Oh, he's afraid we're looking for him. Anything else I can do for you? What can you tell me about these catacombs? He smiles wryly. Haven't explored too much of it, to be honest. Got lucky finding this little corner of it. But let me think. Well, that canal there, that's Grogan's canal. Grogan was the dwarf that planned the whole thing. It runs up through to Andra's gift, spills out into the sea there. Otherwise, it's just a lot of bones. There's the warrens for people that couldn't afford better, but it's all flooded now. The fancier folks, they have their own resting places down here. Drier places. The Dukes of the Deerwood are down here, actually, if you want to pay your respects. Have you seen a woman named Rowyna? He shakes his head. Sorry, but I don't know anyone by that name. I know I'm not the only one down here. However, I hear voices now and then from across the canal. Sounds like they're coming from the northwest. Yeah, that would be where we came from, I'm guessing. The Crucible Knights have put a heavy price on your head. Eorn's mouth falls open, and his eyes widen. After a few moments, he turns away, his brows furrowed. I thought they'd want to keep things quiet, at least. I didn't think they would... Very well. It's true. I've been hiding from the knights down here, but it isn't what you think. He ducks his head. It was an accident. It's been hard for me here in Defiance Bay. I suppose I thought if I got involved in city business, if I made the right friends, it would get easier in time. And it did, really. I made a name for myself. A place. People actually listen to me when I talk. Well, they used to. People can get very passionate about these things. We were discussing, I think it was shipping agreements, of all the things to fight over. But this one night, this man, he got very angry. I think maybe he'd had a little too much at the inn. And I guess he didn't like an Orlan talking back at him. I struck him. He came towards me, and I hit him, and he went over like a tree. I guess he struck his head on the way down. Eorn lowers his gaze and shrugs helplessly. Turns out he was a knight. The Crucible Knights won't care how it happened. They just want me gone. They won't let me live long enough to see the rope. Please. He looks at you with a pleading expression. I just want to get out of this city. The second I can get money for passage, I won't trouble anyone again, I swear it. I'll live quietly. But you can't... Please, you can't tell them I'm here. Oh, wow. Number two is very generous. Gonna take the middle ground. Just tell me a secret's safe with me. Not that I'm cheap with my money, but, I mean, we have plenty. But... I don't see any reason we should help him other than the knights are... Well... I don't really like the knights. Your secret is safe with me, Eorn. Thank you, he says with feeling. Truly, I won't be here much longer, if I can help it. Just have to get the coin together. We need to talk about his past? Eorn, we need to talk about your past, I guess. Eorn's expression falls. Yes? I've told you what happened. I only beg you not to tell anyone. Oh. Now I have no choice other than to apprehend him, attack him, or give him the 300. Fine. Here, this should be enough to buy your passage out of Defiance Bay. He stares at you in disbelief. But this is... His face twists as he struggles for words. They said you were a kind soul, but I wouldn't have imagined. This will see me out of the city, and well away. I'm not sure I could ever thank you enough. But here, take this. I hope it's some use to you on your journey. You have my lasting gratitude, friend. I should get ready.